Hello, it is Mary, and this is Mokadok.
Mokadok!
Before I start this video, like, comment, subscribe. Turn on your notifications so you can see whenever I post another video. Let's get right into this. Happy Valentine's Day. In the comments. Are you having a good Valentine's Day? Again, if you've been watching my videos, you'll know what's going on with that. It's still not 51 days. By the time you watch this, it will be closer to saying goodbye to this house. So, like I've been saying, I want to try to as many videos as I can so I don't have to worry about doing videos while I'm in the process of moving wherever I move. So, what this video is about? This video is about relationships. Yes, I know I'm not in a relationship right now. If I was in a relationship, you probably will or will not know. But these are some of the things that could help you grow your relationship. It could be any kind of relationship. Friendship. Relationship. An intimate relationship. That's what I was talking about. So, some of the things you can do is starting off, get to know yourself and who you are, what you want to be, know what you want in your partner and in your relationship. To make sure you can have a long-lasting relationship. If you're someone that don't want a long-lasting relationship, I don't know what to say. Because I would prefer to be with one partner. So, after I tell you some of these things, I'll explain why being with one partner is actually a good thing. I know it works with polyamorous relationships, but even in those kind of relationships, you should still do some of the things that you can do to make sure it's long lasting. So, getting to know yourself, loving yourself, self-care, making sure your mind, your spirit, everything is aligned and good. Because if it's out of balance, if you're out of balance and your partner's not in line also, it will cause so much chaos into your relationship, your life. Your mental, physical, emotional stuff. You need that all for yourself aligned. And make sure you are on even levels with all that. Because like I said, you don't want your mind and all that stuff out of line. Because it would not be good. You'll have chaos. Some people love chaos, but it is not good for a relationship. Communication. Before you even get into the relationship, know what you want. Know if you want just a short-term relationship. Friends with benefits. Friends. So on, so on, so on. and have communication with whoever you are friends with, in a sexual relationship, physical, anything. Because you want them to be in line. Because you want to be on the same level. If you are not on the same level, and let's say you're here and you want this and they want this, you're never going to be there. Some people can be like that in their friendship or their relationship because they know what each other wants and each other's thinking. And they've been friends for a long time or doing whatever. And they can deal with that chaos. Because if they're already chaotic and you bring that in, make sure you communicate. I keep hearing the water in my tank make noise. I do not know what's going on over there. I'm sorry about this. You need communication. You need understanding. If you kind of need balance in a relationship, because you want, if someone's not having a good day, you want to be there for emotional support and all that. So you want to, like, kind of play tennis or ping pong, volley off of each other. So if one's not having that stable in their life, and the other can be the rock, so they can lean on you, and you give them emotional support, or vice versa. The big thing is communication. You need communication. Honesty. Let's say you want a relationship, but the person that you're with, or you're getting to know, don't want a relationship. They just want what they want. Being honest with the person up front and telling them, hey, I just want this. Or I want this. Make sure you're honest with them. Because telling lies, you've got to keep up with those lies. And the more lies you tell, the more lies you got to keep up with. So honesty is the best policy. They say that in everything, in work, in anything. Honesty is the best policy. You want to know what's going on. Because if the person isn't being truthful and honest to themselves, or what's the situation, that will pull the other person that is trying to be mentally stable and loving themselves, pull them out of that. Communication, honesty, being loyal, respectful for you, yourself, and your body. You need all that. And there's so much more. You're supposed to learn off of each other. You're supposed to teach each other things. If you are both, let's say you're both Christian, or you're both spiritual, but you read a Bible, do that together. Because even though you are trying to get yourself to wherever you're trying to go, if you're doing it together, you can help each other get to that stage where you want to go. So yeah. For me, like it's the ones I just said, honesty, communication, loyal. There's so many more that I can't even think of them all right now. But those are three big things to have any relationship work and last over a long time. Because if you are honest with each other, you have the communication, you both have self-love and know yourself and who you are, that it should make a relationship work. Now we're going to get into the part that I was trying to talk about earlier. So, this part is polyamorous would be probably the same way. But since I'm not polyamorous, I am just Mary. And I know I could probably never be in a poly relationship. I probably could, but I probably couldn't. And it depends if I was in that kind of relationship. It depends if I'm sleeping with someone and someone else is the rock. Not the rock. Someone else is just emotional and spiritual and all that. We connect like that. Maybe. But then again, I'm also the type of person, try it once. If you don't like it, don't do it again. So there, yeah, there's that. But most people are like, they don't want relationships. They just want people they're gonna sleep with. So think of it this way. When you start thinking about having a relationship and having a relation, just having a relationship with someone. If you are not going to have a poly relationship where you all agree and you all are on the same page and all that, and if you are going to be getting married, I know you can legally only be married to one person, but you could be emotionally, physically, emotionally, and spiritually tied together in a relationship. So let's say this paper is one person. And this one person sleeps with someone. That this person that they sleep with isn't the person that they marry. It's just a relationship. We'll throw that in there. Let's say that relationship breaks up and they go find another relationship. They're longer relationship, but it don't work out, and they were physically together, so they had two relationships that they were physically, they done things in bed, we'll say it like that. Then they get in another relationship. It's a little bit longer. They still don't want to get married. There we go. They break up. They get in another relationship. They have physical contact and doing things in bed. There's another relationship, and that relationship ended. Let's say they get in another relationship, and that relationship ended, and they were physical and emotional and all that. Let's say they finally, this whole piece is, they finally find the person that they get married to, love, and honor. And they're forget together until death do them part. You go from a whole heart to pieces ripped out. I'm trying to put that together. Mocha's over here snoring. So you go from that right there. You go from this right here to that right there. Every time you sleep with someone, you give them a piece of you. So instead of having the whole, you have parts of you missing. And every time you sleep with someone, your spirits intertwine. So when you kiss your first relationship and do sexual things with your first relationship, that next relationship gets part of. So let's say So let's say that's you. This right here is one relationship that you are doing physical and mental. You kiss, you have fun times in the bedroom. So that. And then this side is another person. And that one's another person. And that's another person. And that's another person. Those are two more. So, every time you sleep with someone, your souls intertwine. So, that one person sleeps with everyone that you sleep with, or kiss everyone you sleep with. So, you got to think about that. When you're having a relationship, you have to think about all that. Because, on top of it, you got to remember who you've slept with. Because what if someone goes out and they're dishonest and they tell you, hey, they come back to you and say, hey, I have a, back in the day when I was growing up, it's STD or STI. And they come to you and say, hey, I have a STD and this is what it is. Or I have a STI, and this is what it is. And you're only sleeping with that one person. You'd be like, how did you get that? Because I didn't give it to you. So you need to be honest with what you want. Because if they want other people plus you, and all you want is that one person, you need to make sure you are on the same levels in the same thing. Wavelengths. Because you don't want to give yourself out to everyone. And not have everything in return. I know this is kind of weird Valentine's video, but since I really don't have a Valentine's but Mocha, it could be a good video to talk about, because you do need to talk about that kind of stuff with the partner, you need to talk about your sexual past relationship. You need to talk about, get to know them and tell them what's going on with you, what's going on with them, because you can work on each other, work on yourself while you're in a relationship. If you're in a relationship and you feel like you are changing, tell your partner, hey, something don't feel right with me. I need to start working on myself tomorrow some more. I need to do self-care to myself to make sure I am 100% for this relationship, if you want a long-lasting relationship. Because the more you give, the more you got to work on yourself. Because you don't want to give all yourself to that, because you'll end up having nothing. So, again, happy Valentine's Day. I hope you have a wonderful day with whoever you're sharing your Valentine's Day with. Mine will be with Mocha.
Mine will be with Mocha. He's my Valentine's Day. He's my Valentine. Yeah. He's my Valentine.
I don't know if I'm going to be moving in a house or still trying to figure out what's going on. Because technically I should have gave a 30-day notice already. No. Not going to think about that. So yeah. I hope you have a wonderful Valentine's Day. And every day, love yourself. Do self-care. Take care of yourself. Because you are the only person. You need to make you happy. And yes, people will make you happy, stuff will make you happy, but you will truly only make yourself happy. So, have a happy Valentine's Day. Like, comment, share, subscribe, turn on the notifications so you know whenever I post a new video. Catch me in the next one. Bye!